First up, let's talk cricket. Sri Lanka on Sunday put on the perfect game, inspired by tight bowling in the death overs. Restricting India to just 130, the Lankans then, led by their veteran Kumar Sangakkara, overhauled India's target with plenty to spare, winning their maiden World T20 championship. Before we talk about the fallouts for India, take a look at how the match went.
The Indian batsmen were put under pressure right from the start as the Lankans struck early, dismissing Ajinkya Rahane in the second over. Rohit Sharma and Virat Kohli then joined forces to steady the innings, the duo putting on a 50-plus stand.
To give Kohli that breathing space.
Rangana Herath broke the partnership, removing Rohit Sharma. But Kohli, who has been India's most consistent performer in the tournament so far, slammed a fabulous half century of just 43 deliveries.
50 for Virat Kohli, hard working 50.
While the Daily lad carried his bat, some tight bowling from the Lankans in the final overs restricted India to 130 for 4.
They did come back for 2, direct hit, they'll go upstairs.
In response, Sri Lanka too got an early blow, with Mohit Sharma getting rid of Kusal Parera.
First catch, first wicket for India.
Dilshan and Mahila Jayawardene then kept the scoreboard ticking for the Lankans.
Beautifully played, silky hands, soft hands.
But Ashwin got the better of Dilshan.
It's going to go all the way for 6, is it? No, the catch!
Before Raina too got his first wicket of the night.
On is he, yes. He needed a wicket goal.
The Lankans were in a spot of bother when Lahiru Thirumane also returned to the pavilion in no time.
They continue to take wickets. See, India. Ian Gould's finger goes up.
But the ever-reliable Kumar Sangakkara came to their rescue. He, along with Thisara Pereira, took the Lankans closer to the target.
Will that go to the boundary?
And with 13 balls to spare, this shot ensured Sri Lanka were the new World T20 champions.
Oh, well, it's amazing. It's a feeling that I can't explain. This is the first time that I've been a part of a side that's won a World Cup. We've been disappointed 4 times before.
Sri Lanka, the new champions of the ICC World T20. Well played.
With Sameep Rajguru in Dhaka, Sharad Sapaiya, Headlines Today.
What a farewell it turned out to be for Kumar Sangakkara and Mahila Jayawardene. But for India, what went wrong in the final? Was it just the fact that Sri Lanka bowled exceptionally well, or was it that India was found wanting? Despite a brilliant run in the tournament, were India's traditional weaknesses exposed at the final hurdle? The batting didn't fire around Virat Kohli, while the bowlers seemed to be too dependent on conditions to be potent. Was playing UV at number 4 a mistake? Take a look at the questions that remained to haunt India after that defeat against Sri Lanka.
The fans were furious.
All eyes on Yuvraj Singh. Hit out or get out.
Captain Kohli was anxious. And the player of the tournament frustrated. In just a matter of 4 overs, Team India lost its golden opportunity to complete cricket's Grand Slam. A woefully out-of-touch Yuvraj Singh came in before MS Dhoni and informed Suresh Raina and failed to accelerate in the death overs.
But all credit to the bowlers. Look at the change in the dugout now, in the Indian dugout.
And the Indian camp could sense defeat even before they played out their 20 overs. Things went from bad to worse when skipper Dhoni himself failed to connect the ball properly. And the man of the moment, who was unbeaten on 70 after 16 overs, could face only 8 deliveries in the last 4 overs. The pressure of the final certainly got to the men in blue.
No timing all day. Yuvraj Singh has gone 311, it's 119 for 3.
As the same bunch who easily rotated strike in the previous matches played out as many as 48 dot balls.
They're not sitting there being a defensive tactic by holding Malinga back too much, rather than maybe taking the attacking option and taking it early.
Posting only 130 in their 20 overs.
Outstanding, that's with Malinga, they will try and come back for 2.
The match was lost even before our bowlers came back to defend the total. And Sangakkara and company eased to their first World T20 title.
Sri Lanka, the new champions of the ICC World T20, well played.
A glorious unbeaten run came crashing down at the final hurdle for India.
The 2014 champion Sri Lanka.
While they played better than expected, especially after their poor run in the Asia Cup, some questions still persist.
Well, I think in the middle overs, our batsmen, they tried their best to get going, but it was one of those days, you know, where we couldn't really convert the kind of start we got.
Is the Indian batting lineup too dependent on Virat Kohli? Are India masters of chases but susceptible when put under pressure to set the target against a quality attack? Is Yuvraj Singh past his prime? And finally, is the Indian bowling attack potent only in conditions extremely suited to spinners?
He covers up a lot of the weakness of this Indian batting with his exemplary form, exemplary consistency and out of the world batting.
All the good work done in the run-up to the final seems to be exposed against Sri Lanka.
Oh, delightful. That's why he's one of the best players in the world, Sangakkara.
Had India only flattered to deceive? With Sameep Rajguru in Dhaka, Shivani Gupta, Headlines Today.
Not quite today, not for lack of effort, just didn't happen for Yuvraj Singh today.
And we discussed these issues with Headlines Today's expert Sourav Ganguly. He was all praises for Sri Lanka's death bowling that proved to be the difference between the two sides. Listen into what our experts had to say about India's defeat in the final.
Yeah, it is too dependent on Virat Kohli, to be honest. But that's the way it is. But you got to give credit to the way Sri Lanka played today. You know, I've seen cricket for such a long time. I've played cricket for such a long time. And I was speaking to Wasim Akram at the commentary box. And I said, you know, I've not seen anybody bowl so well at the death as Lasith Malinga did today to Virat Kohli and Mahendra Singh Dhoni. In the last four overs, India just got 19 runs.
Yeah.
So you have to give credit to the way Sri Lankans batted. At first, when Sri Lanka won the toss and fielded, I felt it may not have been the right decision, because if India gets 160, 170, Sri Lanka would not have been able to chase. They lost the last T20 World Cup, batting second against the West Indies. But you have to give kudos to the Sri Lankan bowling attack. Angelo Matthews, Kulasekhara, Senanayake, Rangana Herat, and at the end, Lasith Malinga. I mean, Lasith Malinga has changed all the, the mathematics of the game. He was never the captain. He came in for the last three games and won Sri Lanka a title, which they were looking to win for the last 5 years.
Yeah.
It just goes to show that in sport, and I keep saying that there is no hard and fast rule for success. It's about what you do at that particular moment. And once again, Lasith Malinga's captaincy showed that it's not just about planning, it's not just about preparations before the tour, it's about execution at that particular moment. But I think India has done wonderfully well in this competition. Today they have lost to a side who just bowled outstandingly. You know, you talk about South Africa's fast bowling, you talk about Australia's fast bowling, but Lasith Malinga and Kulasekhara under pressure in a big final today was just unbelievable. What a tournament Rangana Herath had, you know, under pressure every game he stood up for Sri Lanka. We talk about Ravichandran Ashwin, but look at Rangana Herath. Also, Lasith Malinga, think about the decision he took to send Thisara Perera up.
Yeah.
Everybody, including Shane Warne, was saying, put in Angelo Matthews. He would knock it around one single, and then win the game for Sri Lanka because there was not much to score. But he thought differently. He thought out of the box. He got in a player who would have got 20, 25 and won the game for Sri Lanka. And if he would have got out, then Sri Lanka could have been in lot of trouble with another wicket there. But that is what it's about, winning big competitions. It's about taking the gamble. And I must give a lot of credit to Lasith Malinga with the way he's gone about his job. And I think it's also a fitting finale for the three greats, for the two greats, Sangakkara and Jayawardene. What a service they have done to Sri Lankan cricket. You know, Sachin Tendulkar played his last World Cup winning it in Bombay. And this was Jayawardene's and Sangakkara's last World T20. And they finished on the winning side. So there is justice somewhere up if you put in and if you give everything. Four consecutive world finals Sri Lanka didn't win. And they won the last time when their two champions were about to finish this format of the game.
The experience made all the difference. Kumara Sangakkara, once you hit that four and six of Ravindra Jadeja, you know, the feet start moving, you grow in confidence. And for people who've been around, and he's a legendary figure in international cricket, you know, everything starts working for you. It's in the initial period, the 5, 7, 10 deliveries that you try and get some of these legendary guys out, then you can put some pressure. Once these guys get past 10 runs, it's very hard to, you know, get that wicket until unless they make a mistake themselves. But you're absolutely right. I guess, you know, build up to the final, Team India won everything very convincingly, you know, with the kind of form that they were in. It's just that I guess we've got to give credit where it's due. I think for me, the eight overs that changed the game, Shivani, were Rangana Herat's four overs and also Senanayake. The way those two spinners bowled with the game plan, and it was with the kind of form that Virat Kohli has been in. He's the only guy who could go out there and deal with them. Apart from Virat Kohli, none of the batsmen could handle the Sri Lankan spinners. Outstanding display of spin bowling.
And you know, Yuvraj Singh has won you two World Cups, 2007 to 2011. So let's not just make a single player as a scapegoat. I know you talk about Ajinkya Rahane, you talk about Rohit Sharma. They played well in this competition. But I'm not too sure. They bat at the top. They have to play match-winning innings. You look at all great players of the past, all players who open for teams. They see through. Once they get set, they see through to 20 overs. That's what Virat Kohli does. So sometimes when you're batting at the top in T20 format, you cannot just blame people down the order. You also have to ask questions at the top of the order that why do you every time get out on 20s, 25 and 30s when you actually should look to bat 20 overs, get to 80, 90 and take the team to 160, 170. Because one must remember, the opportunity at the top is a lot more in T20 cricket than guys coming at number 5, number 6. They get the new ball, they get the time to get set, and once they get set, they cannot throw it away. So it's a lot of reasons why India couldn't get past Sri Lanka today. But at the end of all, I have seen one of the best bowling displays in a World Cup final for a long, long time.
We've said it, Saurav said it last night, we've said it 150 times on our show. He's a true genius. And obviously, I mean, he's got to build this team around him. But you know, it's like the 2003 World Cup. Sachin Tendulkar, 673 runs. You go and ask Sachin. He did not even realize it was a gold bat that was presented to him as the man of the tournament award. So will it be for Virat Kohli. You don't play for individual milestones. You play for the team to win. That's what Virat Kohli is all about. That expression in the semi-final, when Mahendra Singh Dhoni blocked that ball, Virat Kohli's expression was, what the heck, come on, finish it off. You know, let's win this game. That's what Virat Kohli is. Selfless team man. So he will not revel in this Man of the Tournament award. He would have wanted India to win. His time will come, and this will make him more hungry, give him more incentive and more inspiration to perform in the future.
Yeah, that's why I told you before the match, the way Lafitte has been handling the team is really well. He has played a lot of T20 cricket, and he played a lot of IPL cricket, and he has been an experienced campaigner for a long time. So he handled the team really well, and I think the bowling changes will be the Mahila and Sangakkara is a big brand players. Both of them have been playing good figures under pressure. They have been performing, and I think the Mahila also did a fair bit. But I think Sangakkara has been really good, and he knows the responsibilities. They lost three wickets, played a responsible inning for Sri Lanka.
We are a small island from nowhere, so it's a small island, so we keep on producing cricketers like such as Malinga, Mendes, Rangana, so many cricketers we have been Sangakkara, Mahila. So we'll be producing a lot of cricketers in the near future as well. This is not only for them, because it's for the whole country as well, because we were waiting for such a long time, because we have been coming for last five finals and we couldn't win, all public was waiting. So I think it's good for the country, and I think the boys are delivered it. So that's the way, because we can see another 1 year, same there is a one more World Cup. So hopefully if they can get that, I'll be more happy.
So listen in to what Indian fans had to say on India's defeat in the World Cup final. We'll be back in just 2 minutes.
We are extremely disappointed. But it's a bad luck, hard luck. Fantastic bowling by Sri Lankan people. Obviously, nothing to say. And some 40 runs, 30 runs shortage has made a big difference. And terrific fielding by Sri Lankan.
Where do you think India, you know, went wrong?
The batting of Yuvraj Singh made us feel very bad. If Yuvraj Singh would have batted well, we would have expected India to win. So I think Yuvraj Singh was the main reason for India's loss today.
How disappointed are you? India could not win this match. The score was not good enough.
As in the starting, we were thinking that India is going to win. And after getting...
I know you were backing every ball.
Yeah, but after when Yuvraj got the batting, he actually lose 22 balls on which he scored only 11.
Is it becoming one man show? Is it becoming just Virat Kohli and that's it? I mean, Yuvraj Singh hasn't scored today. What do you have to say?
Yeah, Virat Kohli has performed well in this match and in every match.
Tournament.
Yeah, entire tournament.
Becoming one-man show.
No, but we can't say that it's one-man show. As the bowler, Mohit Sharma has also improved.
Okay, in batting, let's ask another fan. Is it Virat Kohli all the way? You are a big fan of Virat Kohli. Is it Virat Kohli all the way?
Yeah, it's only Virat Kohli who's taking the team through the series.
आज के मैच देखिए काफ़ी डिसअपॉइंट हुआ, लेकिन हमारे पास इतने अच्छे अच्छे प्लेयर रखे हुए हैं इंडिया में, धोनी, विराट कोहली, सुरेश रैना, उसके बावजूद भी हमने कुछ कर नहीं पाया। हालांकि आज विराट कोहली ने बहुत अच्छा खेला, लेकिन टोटल स्कोर अच्छा नहीं बन पाया। काफ़ी समय से हम लोग वीरेंद्र सहवाग का वेट कर रहे हैं, लाइक वो का मतलब उन्होंने रिसेंटली फर्स्ट क्लास में काफ़ी अच्छे रन मारे हैं, उन्होंने सेंचुरी मारे 60+ मारा है, तो हमें वीरेंद्र सहवाग काफ़ी बहुत देर से इंतजार हो रहा है, लाइक कर रहे हैं हम लोग।
आपको लगता है कि आज युवराज सिंह का भी जो फॉर्म था, आज उतने बड़े अच्छे फॉर्म में नहीं थे?
आज उन्होंने वैसा स्कोर नहीं किया जैसे वो जिस शॉट्स के लिए, जैसे छक्कों के लिए वो जाने जाते हैं, बट बेटर लक नेक्स्ट टाइम।